What's good, YouTube? It's your boy, Keto Freak. Make sure y'all like, comment, and subscribe, because it's free, you feel me? Hey, hold on, man. Don't start my shit, my nigga. But I'm coming at y'all with a three horrifying real chat room horror stories, you feel me? Shout out to Cairo for sending this motherfucker. You know I said I got you, gang, I got you. I can't miss a day of upload. Now, I'm kind of mad, bro. Ain't gonna lie. I got home, I had to play my little Madden League game and shit, my nigga. And I will be on 2K tonight, probably live streaming it, most likely. But y'all can copy my build if y'all want to. I'm finna go crazy. Block my words. I'm finna go crazy, my nigga. Finna go stupid. But I fucking lost my Madden game, my nigga. I ain't gonna lie, my uncle partner Smoke did it to my ass, my nigga. He was spreading me and shit, my nigga. I don't know how to play I don't know how to play linebacker user, bro. I didn't read the rules properly and shit, my nigga. I was making simple-minded mistakes and shit, and that shit pissed me the fuck off, my nigga. Now I want my, bro, I want my revenge, my nigga. And I'm gonna get it. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, man, fuck all that, man. Fuck all that losing and shit. My niggas getting injured and shit, man. Fuck that shit, man. You know what I'm saying? I'm coming at y'all with a real nigga video, man. Y'all love these scary vids and shit. You know what I'm saying? We growing fast, my nigga. I don't even know where I'm at. I gotta look. Last time I checked, I was at like 475. You know what I'm saying? But I appreciate all the love and support. All my new subscribers. I love all y'all. You know what I'm saying? We gonna go crazy. I love all my gangers. You feel me? Y'all can hit me up on Instagram. DM me, my nigga. I ain't no bougie nigga. Y'all can hit me up anytime, bro. I'm there. When I got time to respond, I'm gonna respond if I ain't busy, gang. 9 times out of 10, I be busy, but I respond to all. Simple as that, my nigga. Ain't no excuse for me not responding, bro. If I don't respond, my nigga, just spam me. I'm going to respond. But, yeah, man. I appreciate all the love and support. You know what I'm saying? Make sure y'all like, comment, and subscribe because it's free. Let's get into the video. I ain't going to talk y'all head off. I got food on the way, my nigga. I'm hungry as shit. And then that's another thing, my nigga. I lose the game. I'm trying to get some food, my nigga. I'm trying to Apple Pay my brother some food. I mean, Apple Pay my brother some money and shit. My nigga, my Apple Pay fucking up, my nigga. It ain't working. I swear to God. Nigga, Cash App ain't working. Apple Pay ain't working. None of that is fucking working. My nigga, I'm like, bro, what the fuck is wrong with this shit? So I did it the old-fashioned way. I created a guest account and did it myself. You know what I'm saying? Now, as for my partner, I tried to send him some money. The shit wasn't working, gang. I swear to fucking God. I'm not making this shit up. It's not working. It's not. Now, as y'all can see, my nigga, look at this shit, bro. I'm going to keep it a buck 50, bro. Look at this shit. Look at this shit, man. This shit better not be old Houdini now. Look at this shit. Look at this shit. It just loads like this, bro. I swear to fucking God, my nigga. Now, I got my card on this shit. Y'all ain't getting my information. But the shit just low, my nigga. And it don't go through, bro. And then it says an error. Fuck that shit, man. I don't know why I'm showing all that shit. This nigga mad. Oh, God. It's just been a stressful night. A stressful night. Oh, God.
This happened one winter night at my friend Luke's house. We'd planned to have a sleepover since both of Luke's parents were out of town for their anniversary. It was probably about midnight when the two of us got bored and figured we'd go downstairs to the house's unfinished basement where Luke's family computer was. The computer was...
Yo, why everything always happened in the basement though, gang? Like, real shit. Stop going to these basements, bro. They be haunted, my nigga. If you got a house with a basement, my nigga, I pray for you. Hakuna Matata, my brother. Simple as that, bro. Because I don't play about ghosts and shit. Bro, that shit is real. That paranoia shit is real, my nigga. I would not walk downstairs by myself in the dark for nothing if I don't got nothing with me, bro. I can't do it, bro.
It's really old and huge.
You know what I'm saying? I gotta have my fist with me or something. You know what I'm saying? A flashlight or something. I cut on all the lights before I go down there, motherfucker. Now, I know my house. So I'm kind of capping, bro. I know my house and shit. But in a random house, bro, I'm not going nowhere.
Huge in comparison to what we have today.
Night, in the dark.
So, naturally, it was also extremely slow. But we could still visit many popular websites at the time, so long as we had enough patience for them to fully load. One we would visit quite often was called Omegle.
Oh, Omegle.
As far as I know, this site is still really popular today.
It is.
It's basically an online video chat room type site where you get paired up with random strangers. You talk to someone until you get bored, and then you skip to the next person. That's all there really is to it. We did this for a few minutes and met a few different people, but nothing really of note. Now, this was around the time when Omegle first added the feature where you could input your interests and get paired up with people who put in the same interests as you. We both thought it would be funny to put in the name of our town. We did this and then clicked the start a chat button. It took a minute to find someone to connect us with, but eventually the loading circle went away and the chat showed the usual "you're now chatting with a random stranger" message. The other person's video screen was just black, which kind of caught us both off guard.
Hey, one thing about me, if I'm on anything, apps like that, Monkey, anything, FaceTime, my nigga. If I FaceTime you, my nigga, and your screen black, this is for ladies. That bitch, I'm getting hit the X button immediately. I would have hit the skip button on Omegle immediately, my nigga. I don't, bro. If it's dark, my nigga, what's the, bro? I'm not chatting with no weirdo, bro. You know what I'm saying? Well, why is you on this motherfucker in the dark, bro? Like, you gotta be on some weird shit. Y'all honestly just think about it, bro. A nigga chatting in the, bro, a nigga is on Omegle, my nigga. And he has his lights off in the room just clicking the person that come up, or they come up with more people. Where are your attentions, my boy? You are in the dark, bro. Honestly, think about it. What are your attentions? It's no, that's not smart at all. There's no reason for that. You gotta be aware.
The two of us both squinted our eyes and got closer to the screen. We even turned up the brightness all the way in the computer's settings, thinking it was an issue on our side. But it was still just complete blackness. Luke took over the keyboard and started typing in the chat.
Hey dude, I think you forgot to turn on your webcam.
Almost instantly a reply came back. It was a link, a really long one consisting almost entirely of just random nonsense characters.
Yeah, y'all niggas dumb.
If it weren't for the blue colored underline, I honestly probably would have thought it was just text.
I wouldn't be in this position, gang.
Luke moved the mouse
really
over
would.
It and looked at me, just before being looking back at the screen and clicking it. A new tab opened. It was completely black, just like the guy's video feed. We started randomly clicking around the site to see if there was anything to it. No, nothing happened.
The nigga just got y'all address with
that
leak.
We clicked back to the Omegle tab, and we're about to ask what the site even was. But before we could, we noticed another chat message had been sent.
I can see you guys.
Luke typed back some smart-ass response like,
yeah, because our camera actually works, unlike yours.
I guess that did it, because a few seconds later, and the loading screen once again showed up, followed by another random stranger. Meaning whoever that was had disconnected the chat. We continued talking to a few other people for a while longer. Eventually, this scratching sound came from the speakers. It wasn't coming from Omegle.
Oh, shit.
We started flipping through the few tabs we had opened in the hopes of finding which one was producing the sound. That's when we came to the tab we had opened earlier. It was no longer black. A video was playing, and it now looked like a road of some sort. We could even see a couple cars passing by. But there was no one else around. We continued watching as the camera began walking down the street, passing by trees and dimly lit gas stations and closed shops. Finally, the camera turned into a small suburb. My heart dropped when I recognized the location. It was about a quarter mile from where we were. The camera turned from street to street, hiding behind trees and streetlights.
I would have been like, oh yeah? Oh yeah? Oh yeah, come on.
Lights.
Come on.
Our eyes were glued to the screen as we both prayed it would make a wrong turn. Finally, it rested on one house at the end of a cul-de-sac. It was Luke's house. Luke and I locked eyes with each other. We both sprinted to the top of the stairs and locked the door leading to the basement. We then turned off all the lights down there. When we returned to the computer screen, the camera was now in the backyard. It was like—
That's what I'm saying. Y'all locking the door, panicking and shit, my nigga. You can see where he at, bro. You can literally see where this nigga at. Man, bro, if I know where you... Bro, man...
It was searching for something. It then stopped on a flower pot.
You know where this nigga at, gang?
My hand reached down in front of the camera and pulled out a hidden spare key to the house. Panicked, I held my finger on the power button to the computer and the screen went black. We now sat in complete darkness. We hid under the desk and just listened. The familiar creaking from the back door echoed out from upstairs. Heavy footsteps followed. This had to have gone on for at least 10 minutes, during which there was nothing we could do. The home phone was back upstairs. Eventually, the footsteps came right up to the downstairs door. We could hear the handle slowly turn until it was stopped by the lock.
God, it was scary, bro.
The footsteps walked away and faded into complete silence. We waited there for an hour, when finally we built up the courage to unlock the basement door and make a run for the phone. And that's exactly what we did. We made it back to the basement and relocked the door immediately. We dialed 911 and explained our situation to the operator as best as we could. To sum up the rest of the night, police showed up and searched the entire house. Nothing was found out of place or missing. Well, nothing but the spare key in the backyard. That was still gone. Luke's parents were informed of the break-in,
he's picking up my
and all they did was change all the locks on the doors to their house. To be honest, I don't think they really ever fully understood the whole situation, or what we saw that night. Luke and I haven't used any kind of online random chat room ever since.
If y'all want to know why I be looking like looking back like that, it's because my green screen. I got to make sure the motherfucker's still up. You feel me? Because, like, this shit be fucking up on some of my videos. That story was cool. Y'all could have avoided that by just skipping a nigga. You feel me? That could have solved all your problems, bro. I'm just be honest.
I was 16 and had just gotten my license when this happened. Back then, I used to spend a lot of my nights online in different chat rooms around the internet. This was back when old school chat rooms were all the rage. One room I visited frequently was a chat room specifically for users in my local area. This is where I first met a girl named Julie. We spent a few nights chatting and getting to know each other. I soon sent her a picture of what it looked like, and she did the same.
Right.
I won't lie, I was really into her. She was definitely my type.
Horny boy.
This went on for maybe 2 weeks, until one night in particular. We were texting back and forth like usual, when she asked me to come over. She lived about an hour away, but like I said, I had just gotten my license, and I actually liked her.
Okay, so I really can't say nothing, bro. I mean, I wasn't driving 2 hours, but I did go 2 hours to see that bitch, though. So I can't say nothing.
So I jumped at the chance to meet her in person. The plan was that I would pick her up at her house, and from there we'd go to IHOP. Because it was already late, and that was pretty much the only place around there that stayed open 24 hours. I got ready and started making the drive to the address she gave me. I was both excited and nervous at the same time. The whole drive took a bit longer than expected, but sure enough, I soon arrived at her place. It was an old farmhouse in what felt like the exact middle of a cornfield.
Oh, I ain't fucking with you.
This wasn't uncommon where I lived.
Oh, turn around.
I guess I was just a bit confused as to how the house got internet way out here.
Oh, hell nah. Turn around,
I walked up to the porch and knocked on the front door.
Oh, shit.
The light quickly turned on from inside and the front door opened. The person standing in front of me was not Julie. Rather, it was some guy much bigger than me who I'd never seen before.
All right, that nigga was Julie.
I told him to pick up Julie.
That nigga was Julie.
He nodded his head and introduced himself as her dad.
Nigga capping, bro.
The problem is the guy.
I remember this story, bro. When a nigga was waiting outside, bro. It was an animated story. Scary story, bro. A nigga was waiting outside for the girl that he wanted to meet up and shit. And the nigga told me he was his dad. And he got in the car and shit. And the nigga fell asleep and shit. The nigga took him on back road, started chasing him in the woods and shit. Bro, that was that nigga acting like he was her.
He was still in college. Regardless, I shook his hand and introduced myself. He gestured me inside. And me wanting to make a good impression, I walked in. He sat down in the dining room of the house, and I asked him if Julie was here. At first, he dodged the question, but after asking a couple more times, he told me she was at work and would be home in a few minutes. Our conversation then veered towards where I live, but he wasn't exactly asking me. He was more so speaking in a way as to confirm this information, which I had only told Julie. I started legitimately sweating and nervously looking around. That's when I saw two silhouettes walking past one of the windows outside near the back of the house. I could tell the man knew I was suspicious, so right then and there I shot up without saying a word and sprinted outside and back to my parked car. There's no doubt I was chased, but I was much faster than the guy. I got in my car and pushed the pedal to the floor back the way I came. Just as I was gaining speed, my headlights revealed a shiny silver object over the floor of the road in front of me. It was a spike strip. I swerved towards the cornfield and somehow was able to miss.
Y'all niggas on some wrong turn shit, my nigga. These niggas got spike strips. Oh, they trying to get you. They trying to get you.
Said. I got back on the road and looked in my rearview mirror. Three silhouettes were chasing me, but slowed pace when they saw that I missed the strip. I got back to a main road, and the harrowing reality that Julie wasn't real, and that I could have almost just been killed slowly started to set in. When I got home, I had one new message from Julie's account.
Where'd you go? Come back.
I didn't respond to this message.
Man, I ain't gonna lie, my nigga, that was tough. I like story two better than story one. You ain't really do no dumb shit, bro. Only thing you did dumb was goddamn see the house and the way it looked at it and still went in that motherfucker. Only thing dumb you did, bro. You at least had some common sense, bro.
My second year of college at the time. I lived with my dog in a small cheap house that wasn't too far away from my school's campus. I had planned to live with a few other friends to help cut down on the rent, but shortly before the school year started, those plans fell through. The isolation was manageable. It's just the amount of rent I had to pay that was slowly killing me. Anyway, back then, online chat room websites were really in their prime. Audio and even video sites were slowly becoming a normal thing. Ever since I got my laptop for school, I would often use it to visit these sites. I met a lot of different people, some who I still call good friends to this day. One night, I got home from one of my night classes, and like usual, got on my laptop to join voice chats in servers with people that had similar interests as me. This went on for a while, until after a couple hours when I met a guy called Chris. We talked for around 45 minutes, college stuff, nothing too specific. It turns out he went to one of my school's rival schools, which gave us a lot to talk about. At one point, I casually mentioned how my computer was acting up. Chris told me he was studying IT and offered to help me fix the issue. I agreed, and he gave me a link telling me to install the application it led me to. I was unfamiliar with the site, but nothing about it yelled sketchy, so I installed it. Chris walked me through a few extra steps. Oh, it was a weird experience.
Like, why is you installing shit you don't know nothing about, my nigga, my guy? That's how y'all computers be crashing into viruses and all types of shit, y'all. Y'all think it be porn. It don't be porn, bro. Be these apps.
The application allowed him to literally control my mouse and do whatever he needed to on my computer. I sat back and watched as he got to work trying to fix the issue. After a while, I had to step out to let my dog back inside the house for the night. Gone for only a few minutes. Just as I stepped back in my room, I noticed something on the laptop quickly being closed out. I dismissed it as Chris just doing what he needed to do. I asked him if the issue was fixed, and he said yeah, that it was. I thanked him and told him I was going to go to bed, because it was now starting to get really late.
You're a weird motherfucker.
I thought he was actually pretty cool, so before I left, we scheduled another time to talk. After that, I closed out of everything, put my laptop to sleep, and
I don't need new friends. I slept
for a few hours. When I opened my eyes, it was still dark outside. I checked the time. 3:30 a.m. My whole room was lit up by my laptop screen, which I believe is what woke me up. I sat up, trying to understand how it could have turned on by itself. I got out of bed and sat down in front of the screen. It was just sitting there on the desktop showing my background. I tried to move the mouse to put it back to sleep, but it wasn't responding. The mouse was frozen.
What's wrong with this shit?
Frustrated, I began continually clicking the mouse, trying to unfreeze it. Nothing was working.
An image then popped up and covered the whole screen.
It was dark. My eyes had to take a second to adjust to it. Soon, I realized that it was a picture of my empty room, like as if the laptop's camera had taken it. I pressed the escape key. I even tried Control-Alt-Delete, but none of it was doing anything. Then, another image appeared. This time, it was a picture of me. It looked like it had just been taken. My heartbeat was picking up speed and was getting louder in my ears. I finally looked up at the laptop's camera. The small light next to it was now on, indicating that it was being used. Then, a video appeared on the screen with a play button in the middle of it. It was me again, now with a horrified expression on my face.
Oh, fuck.
The mouse started moving by itself towards the play button.
Fuck no.
It clicked it and the video started as I desperately put one hand over the camera and the other holding the power button. I held the power button for about 15 seconds when one final image appeared on the screen. It only showed for a brief second before the laptop finally powered off and the screen went black. But I could still tell exactly what the image was of. It was a low quality picture of the outside of my house in the dark. I sat there frozen, taking in what I had just seen.
Niggas be thinking shit like this be all funny and shit. Oh, you think it's funny? You think it's a game, huh? Oh yeah, somebody gotta die tonight.
Breaking the silence was somebody the sound of my dog tonight. Aggressively barking from downstairs. Knowing my dog rarely ever does this, I panicked at the thought of someone trying to break into my house. This would never end up happening, however. My dog's barking slowly stopped and the rest of the night was just silence. The next morning, I moved all of my stuff into a hotel and stayed there until I found a new place to live. Purely out of fear that someone would come back to that house.
Yeah, you smart for that.
I never talked to Chris again, and I still don't know what was done to that laptop. I had school files on that thing that weren't backed up, but I couldn't bring myself to turn it back on. I accepted that they were gone. I ended up setting that laptop on fire and burning it completely.
Hey man, RIP to them motherfucking files, my nigga. I don't need no school files anyways, nigga. Hey, make sure y'all niggas graduate the real shit, bro. All y'all niggas who watch me, man, make sure y'all boy graduate, bro. Do what y'all gotta do. Real shit. I ain't just talking, bro. Get that goddamn diploma, gang. It's your boy, Keto Freak, man. Make sure y'all like, comment, and subscribe, because it's free, and I'm out, bro. I'm talking like I'm an old head, my nigga. I'm young as shit.